So something that people are messing with today is this thing where you can bypass the loading trigger in the stairs here in the windmill. And then get the staff to learn Song of Storms without watching the cutscene. So I'll explain how this works. So on screen here I have this 4-byte value. It's a bit field. The flag's related to something related to Link. It's not exactly his animation. There's a separate set of flags for his current animation, but the important one is you'll notice that when you pull Ocarina, that first byte turns to 8. And when you are queuing up a cutscene with the Ocarina, you'll notice that value is 9, which is important. So this value is important because if you notice in this window here, this is code from the windmill guy. It loads this whole 4-byte value here, does some bitwise math on it, and then checks if the result of that math is greater than or equal to 0. When that value is 8 from just playing Ocarina normally, it will be 0 and it will skip over this code, so it will just jump right over it. But if that value is 9, it will jump in here and run this code. And I can simulate that by skipping that check, and you'll see that the cutscene starts right away. So you'll also notice that normally when you pull out Ocarina, that first byte is 8, right? However, if you're next to a Song of Time block, if you're within its range to play Song of Time to clear it, that value turns to 9, just like it does with the Song of Storms cutscene. So the whole point of this trick is to bypass the loading trigger and the stairs here. And by doing that, you keep the windmill guy loaded so that he's checking that flag every frame, while also giving yourself the ability to set this flag to 9 by being in range of the Song of Time block. Like so. And then when you cancel it, this check is passed and the code in here will run and the cutscene will start. And then you can play Song of Storms and keep it.